Hi, my name is Paxton, and welcome to my channel, One of Us is Teaching. I am a fourth year teacher in upstate New York, but this will be my very first year teaching sixth grade. I am moving on up from second grade to sixth grade, where I'll be teaching math and science. So today I want to talk about some PD kind of books, some teacher books that I found when I was doing my book sort and that I really find helpful in the classroom. In my previous video, I talked about books that I like to use as read-alouds at the beginning of each school year. So if you haven't checked that out, I will link it below and you can go ahead and check that out. So today, like I said, we're going to talk about some professional development type teaching books. The first one I have is The Daily Five, Fostering Literacy Independence in the Elementary Grades. It's written by Gail Bushi and Joan Moser. Totally butchered their names, I'm sure, but they're referred to as the two sisters. Like I said, I'm going to be teaching math and science this year, so this book won't be super relevant to my teaching this year. However, this is a great book. It talks about a teaching model using centers. Basically, it's a centers-based model in the classroom for literacy. These five centers are read to self, partner read, writing, word work, and listen to reading. I'm sure that's not the order that they teach them in. Can't remember that exactly. But it's really great. It talks about how to set up those centers in your classroom, how to utilize all of those things to build great literacy skills. And there's also a section in this book about the Math Daily 3, right here. So that's like the math version of this. Instead of having five centers, they have three centers in math. So I might try and use this in my classroom this year to set up some centers in that way. So it still might be useful to me this year, we'll see. But I do highly recommend this. It can be used with probably any reading and writing curriculum, I would imagine, because this isn't a curriculum, it's just a model to set up managing your classroom, basically. So again, The Daily Five, I highly recommend. Another very important book that I have used to set up my classroom by is The First 6 Weeks of School. It's from the Responsive Classroom Model. And this book really just breaks down, like it says, the first 6 weeks of school. It goes further than that, really, though, and it breaks it down by grade level. So if you're teaching primary, there's a primary section in here that is specific to your age level kids. Same with intermediate or upper elementary students. And it will give you a schedule, basically, for the first day of school, then the first week of school, and then it kind of weans you off for over the first 6 weeks, but it's very helpful for just setting up the classroom environment the way that you want it to be. Getting students used to your teaching style, used to having each other around, introducing materials, introducing centers, what the writing block will look like in your day, etc. I love this. I was gifted this book my second year teaching, and unfortunately not with enough time to really wrap my head around all that this was about and implement it appropriately into my classroom. And this last year I kind of demanded that curriculum kind of take a back seat for the first 6 weeks because I wanted to do this with fidelity. And my administration agreed with me. It was implemented throughout the teaching staff that we were expected to use this for the first 6 weeks of school. And I really noticed a huge difference in how the classroom was managed, in how independent the students were able to be, quicker, things like that. I don't really have enough nice things to say about this. It's phenomenal. And the last book that I have here is called The Invisible Classroom, Relationships, Neuroscience, and Mindfulness in School. It's written by Kirk Olson. And I want to actually read a little blurb on the back of this. I think that's just the best way to describe how great this book is. I guess that kind of makes sense because they wrote it here for a reason. So it says, there's more to a classroom than just a teacher and a group of students. All classroom interactions have invisible neurobiological, emotional, and social aspects. Kirk Olson takes lessons from brain science, mindfulness, and positive psychology to help teachers understand the full range of their students' school experiences. Using these classroom-ready resources, teachers, administrators, parents, and policymakers can make the invisible visible, turning human investment in their students into the best possible learning outcomes. So it's very interesting. Like it says, it talks about brain science, positive psychology, which are things that I just find interesting anyway, but it really helps you get to know the mind of the student in your classroom and who you are teaching and how you can best support them. It is very interesting, and I highly recommend The Invisible Classroom. And those are the three professional development teaching books that I have had in my collection still that I wanted to share with you. I know that there are tons more fantastic books out there, but these are the three that I still have on my shelves that I refer back to and that I really think are pretty awesome. Drop your favorite professional development books in the comments below. I would love to read more. I am always looking to be a better teacher for myself, for my students, you know, the whole thing. And if you are new here, please hit that subscribe button and stick around. Check out my previous videos if you haven't done so yet, and stay tuned for more. I'm hoping to get in my classroom really super soon. I'm feeling pretty anxious about it because I have a lot to do. Like I said, I'm moving to a new grade level, but also a new school, so I am starting classroom setup from scratch completely. So I really want to get in there and get started. But anyway, once I get in there to do that, some classroom setup videos will come. So stick around by subscribing. Please like and comment on this video. I really appreciate it if you do that. And I will catch you guys soon. See you later.